My name is Rahul. I am a telecoms engineer working in Dubai since 2002. I want to ask a few questions. Coming from my background, I think religion is something that following that, you're saved from making having problems in your life. Yeah. My first question is, I recently read a report by a doctor saying that because of marriages in first cousins in Islam, it leads to a higher probability of the fetuses being born as handicaps. Yeah, it increases the probability of the babies born without hands or without legs. So if it was something that could potentially cause harm, it should not have been allowed in Islam. Another point I would like to add to the same question is, recently I suffered a little bit of a BP and I went to the doctor and the first thing he said to me is that stop eating red meat, which is again allowed in Islam. So I would think that if these things could be harmful to the human body, these should not have been allowed by who has created us. So if you can clarify me on that.
The brothers asked two questions. The first question that is talking about consanguineous marriages. Consanguineous marriages means marriage between close relatives. In English, it's called as consanguineous marriages. And in consanguineous marriages, medical science tells us today, there are high chances of genetic problems. And I do agree with the brother. Yes. So why does Islam permit that?
Yes.
It's clearly mentioned in the Quran in Surah Nisa, chapter number 4, verse number 22 to 24, the woman who you can marry and the woman who cannot marry is mentioned there. Amongst them, it's clearly mentioned you cannot marry your sister, and a lady cannot marry the brother, it's mentioned. Neither the father, neither the mother, you cannot marry the brother of your father, the ladies, and you cannot marry the sister of your father. That means the important close relatives are mentioned in the Quran. Brother, sister cannot marry, son and mother, father and daughter, paternal uncle, maternal uncle can't marry. But as far as first cousins are concerned, Islam does give permission. Now, as far as consanguineous marriages are concerned, the maximum problem comes when you marry your direct blood brother and sister. Consanguineous marriage. Even if you marry your direct father, daughter, mother and son, or your uncle, the chances are also there if you marry your first cousin, but negligible, very negligible. So
no,
Islam...
That's not what the report said. The report said that because of marriages in first cousins, not your brothers and sisters, it leads to this problem. And it was from a doctor.
Let me complete.
Gulf News as well, actually.
Brother, let me complete. Even I'm a doctor.
Ah, okay.
Fine. Even I'm a medical doctor.
Yeah.
It's me, medical doctor, with that doctor.
Yeah.
The chances in direct relatives are very high.
Yeah.
If a sister and brother marry, the chances are very high.
Yeah.
If a father and daughter are very high. You have read only one report, you haven't read the other report.
Yeah.
So you only read Gulf News, I read medical books. So right. Gulf News is better or medical books is, brother?
Right, so your point is marrying in first cousins, the chances of getting problem is negligible.
As compared to brother and sister.
As compared to. But still there is a...
Brother, will you let me complete my answer or...
Sorry, yeah, please.
So you have more faith in Gulf News?
No, not really. I'm here to find the truth.
That's right. So what you realize that consanguineous marriage, and I agreed with you. I didn't say it's not there.
Yeah.
So I'm not trying to beat around the bush. But compared, it is negligible compared to direct blood brother and sister. Now, I do agree that there are medical genetic problems in various ways. But this report is there when you have continuously generation after generation. And our beloved prophet said, according to Dr. Ahmad Sakhari says, the prophet said, do not marry against first cousins generation after generation. If you do it once or twice, it is no problem. Yet, even if you marry not cousins also, you can get a problem. Do you know that?
So that
doesn't mean that you stop marriage only.
Right, so there is a hadith which says that do not do it generation after generation.
Yes, but otherwise, generally, there's no problem.
Right.
Fine?
Okay, okay.
So coming to your second question.
Yeah.
You went to a doctor and you said you had high BP.
Yes.
Doctor said you have red meat.
Yes.
So why does Islam allow red meat?
Yes.
You know, my friend went to a doctor and doctor said you had diabetes. Don't have sugar. Brother, why do you have sugar?
Right.
Why? Don't have sugar. My friend went to a doctor. Doctor said he had diabetes. Don't have sugar. Brother, do you have sugar?
Yes, of course.
Why you have sugar? Stop having sugar.
Yeah, but we can live on vegetables. Easily possible.
Can you live without having sugar? Can you live without having sugar? Even vegetarians have sugar, brother.
Yeah.
Are you educated?
Yeah.
MashaAllah. The problem is that person had a problem with his pancreas.
Yes.
In the pancreas, there are islets of Langerhans which break down the sugar. Because my friend had a problem in the pancreas, he could not break down the sugar. Therefore, the doctor said, don't have sugar.
Right.
Well, you have some problem of red meat, you should not have red meat. Others can have red meat.
Right.
The Quran says, a general statement, Quran says, eat what is halal and tayyab for you. There's a verse in the Quran, eat what is halal and tayyab for you. For a person suffering from diabetes, sugar is not tayyab. So according to the Quran, a person having diabetes should have less sugar. It's a general statement. Eat what is halal and tayyab for you. That means certain things which is good for other may not be good for you. But there are certain things which are bad for everyone. Alcohol. Alcohol is bad for everyone. It is prohibited for everyone. Pork is bad for everyone. Therefore, pork has been prohibited for everyone. What do you realize? Certain food, because of the way your metabolism is made, because it's a problem for you, doesn't mean that everyone should abstain from it. Hope that answers the question.